West Ham, you know, his first spell was, you know, underwhelming. I thought it was done, really did. And, you know, when they signed him back, I was like, wow, what is happening at West Ham? You've got to say, he did an unbelievable job last year, though. Absolutely unbelievable. Where did that come from? You know, can he keep it going? Let's hope for their sake, West Ham, that he can. But, yeah, let's dive into their summer. Departures then, Felipe Anderson, 3 mil to Lazio. What happened to him? You know, can you remember how good he was when he first came? He looked like an absolute world beater, and they signed him for good money, I seem to remember. I think they did anyway. But yeah, he was brilliant for a while, and then he just fell off a cliff. Career's really gone into free form, but you know, based upon the last year or so, he's not a miss for them at all. Bob Wayne has gone on a free to Dinamo Moscow. Again, I don't think they're going to miss Bob Wayne either. Arrivals then. So, okay, limited business thus far, but they've brought in Craig Dawson for 2 mil from Watford. He, of course, did pretty good for them last year, you know, decent. A lot of West Ham fans thought they were happy with him. You know, for me, I'm not so sure. I've got a bit of a theory on West Ham in terms of their defensive prowess, and I'll get into that shortly, but West Ham fans like him. And then I think this is a real coup for them. They've brought in Areola on loan from PSG. I think it's a fantastic signing, absolutely fantastic signing. But they need to do some more business, and the window's ticking down. But I think you'll see that they will do some. Contract's expiring then. Yarmolenko's contract's expiring. He is 31 now, so plagued with injuries in his career. What a fantastic player he is, but he's just, how many games can you get out of him? I wonder whether they might decide to cut their losses there and let him go on free. Ben Johnson, I think he'll definitely get a new deal. Ben Johnson, he's played a few games for them now, he's young, can play on either fullback. I think he'll get a deal. Ogbonna has been a stalwart for them now for a while at centre-back, but he is 33. I wonder if this will be his last year, and potentially he'll go on a free as well. Fredericks, his deal's expiring, he is 28. You know, obviously he's back up these days. I wonder whether they will let him go on a free next year and bring someone else in, or whether they're happy to give him another contract as backup. Mac Noble, who of course is retiring at the end of the season, he'll be a big miss for them. They'll be hoping he stays around, surely, as a coach. I mean, he's got a job for life at West Ham now. Guys, as well, it's like detour here. I'm not much of a podcast guy myself. I can't get into them personally. The Peter Crouch podcast is absolutely phenomenal. It is hilarious. I listen to it on all my runs. The Mark Noble episode, guys, there was points where I was close to crying with laughter. I cannot sell that to you enough. Please go and listen to the Mark Noble episode of the Peter Crouch podcast. All the sort of East End Cockney geezer sort of view I've had from Mark Noble was absolutely and utterly confirmed in that episode. Some of the stories he tells are hilarious. Fabianski as well, his contract expires at the end of the year. He is 36. So, you know, I wonder if again they might let this be his last year, and whether they're looking to transition him to back up this year now that they've brought Areola in. Jean De Silva, his contract expires, I think you have to let him go. David Martin as well, another backup keeper at 35, I think he'll be gone. So they've got four keepers. David Martin, as I mentioned, Darren Randolph, who's decent backup to be honest, and he's third choice now. Fabianski, who was their main keeper last year, 10th best in the league last year, he had a really good solid season. But Areola was the 6th best in the league last year, he had a great season, and it was his first year in the Prem. I think he'll come in as number one, Areola. I really, really do. I really fancy him as keeper. But you know, they've got Europa League football, so I think, which, you know, Fabianski will probably play all the Europa League is a Diop be a starting centre back this year for them if he can stay fit. I think he's a good player. I'd give him another go. So yeah, the back line is an area that concerns me. It really does. But they are rumoured with sorry. Close apparently to bringing in Nikola Milenkovic from Fiorentina, who's only 23. I think that'd be a really good signing for them, and I think that would upgrade the back line. I really do. I really, really do. So, you know, they play four at the back. If they had Milenkovic and Diop or Ogbonna at centre back, they've then got the likes of Dawson and another one in there for the Europa League campaign, potentially. I don't think they'll take the Europa League too seriously this year. Cement a good Premier League place again, but they don't have a lot of depth. But yeah, bringing in Milenkovic, they will have some depth at centre back then, and you know, that's good for them then. I think that'd be a good signing. Right back, one of the signings of the season last year, Soufal, 7th best right back in the league, really, really good for West Ham. And they've got Ryan Fredericks as backup, no concerns there. Left back, they've got Aaron Cresswell, who's obviously been a big player for them for a long time. He was the 13th best left back in the league, which is decent enough for a team like West Ham. And they've got Adam Mazowaku as well. I can't see them upgrading that for now, but I do think over the next year or so, that's an area that they could look to upgrade for sure. Centre mid, again, potentially against signing of the season, Suchek, 4th best sort of defensive slash centre mid in the league last year. They've also got Declan Rice, Mark Noble, and they have got Lanzini, who's more of an attacking mid player, who can kind of fill in at centre mid. I think for a team that's in the Europa League, I think they're light at centre mid. I think they've got two unbelievable starting players in Declan Rice, who's one of the shining lights of the Premier League. They've seemingly managed to keep hold of him as well, and I think they are going to keep hold of him. Mark Noble is getting on and looked leggy at points last year. And yeah, I think they definitely need to bring in another centre mid for if Suchek or Rice isn't fit. Because you can't expect them to play all the cup competitions, the Europa League and the Prem. So yeah, I think they want to be bringing someone in. They're not really rumoured with anyone per se at the minute in centre mid. I'll talk you through my options later on as to where I think they could go. They do play sort of a 4-2-3-1, and obviously Lingard played a fair few games for them as an attacking midfielder last year. They had Fornals, who played in there as well, a few games. Ben Rama played a few games as a 10. Lanzini can play in there, and Bowen played a couple in there as a 10 as well. Lingard's gone. You know, and some of those other players do prefer to play in wide positions. Bowen on the left, Fornals on the left or the right, Ben Rama on the left. Lanzini's primarily backup. So, you know, I think they want to look at a number 10 again as well. I do. Again, they're not particularly linked with a player there. Right wing, they've got Bowen, who's their main player, on the right. They've got Fornals, who can play there. Soufal even played a few games as kind of a right midfielder. But he's mainly a right back. And then, of course, they've got Yarmolenko. Had any games last year because of injury, but he's a great option to have coming in on off the right, pinging balls into the top right, top left corner, as we know that he can. But Bowen was their main player on the right last year, and I think he's a great little player. 10th best in the league last year as a right winger. That's really, you know, good standard for West Ham. Left wing, then they've got Lanzini, Ben Rama, as well, and Fornals, who played the most games for them on the left. He was the 12th best in the league. I think Ben Rama is an upgrade. I would love to see Ben Rama playing the majority of their games on the left next season. But again, they're going to have rotation because they've got Europa League football. So Fornals is a great option to have. They've got Lanzini. Guys, for me, on the wings, they don't need to do any business. Bowen, Fornals, Ben Rama, Lanzini, Yarmolenko is absolutely enough for them for all of their cup games. You know, Europa League, Premier League, I'm more than happy with that. No upgrades are needed. I'd just like to see Ben Rama sort of push Fornals to back up. Even Fornals is a really good player. I just think that Benrahma for me is better. I really, really rate him. Strikers then, at the minute, as I pronounce strikers, they've got Mikel Antonio and Sebastian Haller. They are linked with players at striker. Antonio was the fourth best in the league last year. Didn't score tons, but his overall play was great. And Haller was a bit better last year as well when he played. So, you know, decent options. But again, they've got European football now. So, they're linked with bringing in Milenkovic imminently, and that seems like it's definitely going to happen soon. They're also linked with Tammy Abraham on loan, as are a lot of clubs. Whether that happens or not, I don't know. Chelsea clearly want to get a fee for him, and it's looking like they might be able to do so from Italy, from the likes of potentially Inter or Roma. Roma are heavily linked with him. So, you know, I think for European football, to ensure that they're not going to burn out, and you know, we see this with teams getting in Europa League with a thin squad, don't we? They end up finishing like 15th the next year in the Premier League. The West Ham don't want to fall into that trap. So I think they need four players. Now, whether they'll go and do that, I don't know. Centre-back, they're going to get Milenkovic, that seems obvious. Great little signing for them. Brilliant. That goes a long way to shoring them up for me. Centre-mid, now, for me, Suchek and Rice are going to start. So they want to be bringing him back up. I'd like to see them go and try and get Timo Bakayoko on loan from Chelsea. I really, really would. I think that would be a great little signing on loan. You know, I can't see him. I can't see him, you know, getting any game time really at Chelsea. He's linked with going to AC Milan. But, you know, I think I do think that if he doesn't, that could be a great sign on loan. And, you know, this game plays on loan is maybe what they want to do to so they're not spending so much. If not, another good option I think could be Guido Rodriguez from Betis, because he can kind of play as a six as well. I don't think he costs too much, Guido Rodriguez, and I think he'd be really good backup for the likes of Rice or Suchek. So the number 10 position then, I do think they need to bring somebody in here. I think that trying to get Lingard on loan again or signing him permanently would be the best possible option for them if they can pull that off. You know, there's talk that Man United want to keep Jesse Lingard now. I'm not sure about that. I think the playing guy, I think if they could get a decent fee for him, they'd be happy to. Also, somebody like Daiki Kamada from Frankfurt could be a good option if they can't get Lingard. Again, I don't think he costs much. Strikers then, if they can get Abraham, I don't think they're going to be able to, but if they could get Abraham on loan, that'd be great. Sasa Kalacic from Stuttgart would be a really good option for them as well, to challenge the likes of Antonio and Haller. And I'm going to go super left field here, guys. Super left field. I'd also look at Benteke from Palace. I don't think he costs too much because of his age. And he had a really good season last year. And with the way that that they play, you know, he is an Antonio-esque player. I think he'd be a great little option. If they can keep Antonio fit, and they have got Haller, the striker is the position whereby I think they can get by. I do think they can get by with what they've got in Antonio and Haller. So striker would be last on the list. I think centre-back they need to do, and they're going to do. From there, I think they need to get more backup in at centre-mid, and that should be achievable because it's backup you're looking at. You're not looking to bring in anyone to replace Suchek or Rice. And then from there, you know, the third area of priority would be number 10. So that's my thoughts on where